Remember the old Diablo 2 before the Whirlwind nerf? Hydra, Nova, and Frozen Orb? Maybe the Boazon was your thing. Path of Diablo makes all your fondest memories into a reality. While I don't have time to review every single character and all the details, I do want to get into some main points. Firstly, I'll be going over the installation process, community, lag server, patches, characters, and then finally giving my score.
Stay a while and listen.
Battle.net fails to give us the skills we all love growing up, forcing us to adjust our playstyles into moves we just don't love, like Blizzard. Strong, yes, but never had the appeal that Frozen Orb had. Growing up, I never saw a Blizzard source and said, wow, I want to make a character like that. Using Hydra in combination with other skills is the way I remember Diablo 2 in its prime. Nova was powerful and exciting to use when endlessly destroying mobs of cows. And let's face it, Diablo 2 is a 17-year-old game. People play this game for the memories and the way it made them feel. Many players log in to get a piece of their childhood back. And for me, this meant playing until 2 a.m. on a school night, only to go to school feeling drained. But I didn't care. It didn't matter to me, because I knew I was one step closer to finding that high rune I always wanted. Path of Diablo offers you an experience online that you haven't felt in nearly a decade. It's a bot-free server with no hackers, spammers, or dupers. And when you find or trade for an item, you know it's legit. It didn't come from an external website. It came from a legit player just like you and that's seeking a fair trading experience. The installation process for Path of Diablo was by far the easiest I've had of any other mod or private server I played. I literally just downloaded a single file, searched for my Diablo 2 path, that was it. There was no added programs, there was no need for gateways or IP adding, and the best part is you didn't have to downgrade your game to 1.13. It doesn't matter if you have 1.13 or 1.14, either way, you just start playing the game after a single file. It might seem small to some, but for people who played on other private servers where it's much more difficult to connect, frustrating, and downgrading, this is huge. So right off the bat, I fell in love with Path of Diablo's installation process. Community. I really felt at home playing Path of Diablo. The people were helpful, and there's a lot more to be a part of than on Battle.net. See, on Battle.net, you log in, you play with other people, you don't even know them, you save, exit, repeat. Maybe you'll play with them another game or two, maybe not. But you never feel a part of something bigger than yourself. Path of Diablo has a talkative Discord, Reddit page, and even a world chat. This means you become connected to the entire server if you want to. You don't have to, but you can subscribe to it. You can always unsubscribe if it's not something that you're into. Personally, I would like to see a trade chat added. On different servers that I've played, they have trade chats and then they also have general chats. They separate the two. You can subscribe to one of them, you can subscribe to both. It doesn't really matter, but it saves you so much time. You can still play in-game. You don't have to go to a website like Reddit or anything. And honestly, I think that would help Path of Diablo a lot. Lag and server. There's 28 servers to choose from on Path of Diablo. I really love this. There's tons of choices across America, Jersey, North Carolina, Dallas, Buffalo, New York, and the list goes on. There's a server in South America, Israel, France, Canada. You get what I'm saying. If you have a weak connection, you can connect somewhere else. Not like just, oh, we have to play in America, we have to play in Europe. If you have a weak connection, you can go anywhere in the world nearly, and it'll really help you with the lag, and still, everybody plays together. Even though there's 28 servers, you can still all play together at any time and join any other server. It just helps you with connection. Now, I do not blame Path of Diablo for this. Honestly, it's my internet. I don't think it's them by any means. I have less than 2 downloads, sometimes 1 download, so you can't blame the server for that. I just felt like I had to say that, and I felt really bad for people who played in-game with me. If we did bail runs, if we did Tristram runs, I could barely move at times. I was pretty much useless, and sorry guys if you did play with me. If you're looking for a better review of the lag, I would say ask somebody on Twitch because I could not possibly answer that effectively. The patches for this game is one of the best things that has going on. See, they didn't add in too many things so where it doesn't feel vanilla. It still feels very vanilla, just with some new modern updates. It's still the old Diablo 2 we all love, but with quality of life options. Things like gold filters, amazing updated stashes, being able to see another player's gear. These are all updates we need. They're things that Blizzard was too lazy to do. Would it be that hard for Blizzard to add in a filter so you don't have to see piles of gold? Why is it necessary to see 3 gold, 20 gold, 40 gold? Why can't I just filter that out? They patched in awesome things for arrows. You can get different stats on regular magic arrows, and of course on gold arrows. Not to mention splash damage. This is a huge highlight for Path of Diablo. It's kind of unfair that melee characters have to kill things 1-1-1, but instead now when you hit once, it's like you're splashing into the area, right? And Path of Diablo really tried to help out the melee character here. I definitely appreciated that when I was playing on my Barb. As far as the characters, you guys know how I feel about the Sorceress. I'm a huge Sorceress advocate, and for me, it's the same Sorceress that I used to love. You couldn't ask for much more in a Sorceress. The Assassin, new martial arts, is simply amazing. My personal favorite is Blades of Ice, which in my opinion looks like a trap version of Frozen Orb. For the Amazon, you guys know how I feel about the Boazon. Absolutely love, 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 love the Boazon. Shooting Guided Arrow, I mean, PvP back in the day, that was incredible. The memories are surreal. Barbarian has Whirlwind. I mean, do I really need to say more about the Barbarian? Honestly, Whirlwind barbs are back, guys. The Necromancer has a lot of cool new poison skills. I'm not going to ruin them for you. One of them's pretty funny. But there is a new rune word for the Necromancer, and it gives 2 fire golems. Now, I didn't have the time to get 2 ums to make this, but that's freaking sick, man. I was watching that on somebody's stream. 2 fire golems. They've added in so much more. They've made the summoners even cooler. The druid is phenomenal. The druid can now have 7 wolves, dude. They've buffed so many of these characters, added in just a little bit of skills just to update the game. And in my opinion, Path of Diablo has done a fantastic job with the character recreations. So now we need to get into the cons. While I really enjoyed my time on the server, there were some things that I didn't love. In Path of Diablo, teleporting for the Sorceress is now nerfed. I didn't really like this. I didn't really feel like it was necessary. In my opinion, the Sorceress is already a very weak character. After teleporting, you lose 55% of your total defense rating. She's at a disadvantage health-wise, and I never felt like teleporting was overpowered. I know some people do, but I just didn't agree with that decision. And every time you level it up, it goes up by a single percent. So the difference between level 4 and level 5 is 55 to 54. You would have to level up teleport so much to make it go down to 0, if that's even possible. And who's going to level up teleporting like that? Come on, let's be honest. Another decision I did not like was static. Static now can only take away 20% of monster health. 20% really is nothing. It doesn't make me want to level it up. It doesn't even really make me want to get it. I never really saw a problem with 50% of the health, the same way it works in Hell on Battle.net. It's not something you can use in PvP, so 20% to me just seems kind of silly. I'm not saying that 50% is the perfect number, but what I am saying, 20% is just too little. And personally, I would never want to level up static the same way I would never want to level up my teleporting. I would rather spend it on Hydra or Fire Mastery and then get my frozen orbs and all that. So it's just not a skill that's like, oh, I have to level this up for me. Another con is battle orders are now nerfed. So if you get a CTA or call to arms, it's really not worth getting. It's kind of pointless at this. I mean, you'll get a little bit of health, you get a little bit of mana, but the huge nerf on that, again, this decision, I just didn't really like. Alright everyone, so the moment that you've been waiting for, the final score. I really tried my best to give Path of Diablo a fair review, an honest review, not think about any other server while doing it, but it is kind of natural to think about other servers in the back of your mind, but I really just tried my best to erase all of that. At its current state for a mod or private server, I would give Path of Diablo a solid 10 out of 10. 10. This is the way that Diablo 2 should be played. Honestly, this is the game that we all love. Are you kidding me? Whirlwind, Frozen Orb, Guided Arrow? Come on here, guys. New skills, new patches. There's so much endgame content here that I didn't even have the time to review. This is an actual community, a place where you will remember these people and they will help you and you will help them and everybody's a good friend of each other. I can honestly say this is the way that Diablo 2 should be played online. If you're into ladder, it'll show you who's at the top. It's a race there, and you know you're not going against a bot. Not only did they make the old Diablo 2 gameplay more viable, but they even made characters more enjoyable. It made me want to be level 30 so I could finally try out Hydra and it'd be good again. It made me want to get to level 24 to try out a new skill for my barb. It made me want to continue. Whereas Battle.net, I've played so many times. It's the same old thing over and over and over. There's really nothing to look forward to. I already know what's at the end of the road. Path of Diablo, I've never experienced something like this. It's fresh. It's addicting as hell. And if I wasn't deployed, I guarantee you this would ruin my life, but in a good way. If you haven't already checked out Path of Diablo, please do, guys. I'm telling you, it is such a great game. Thank you for watching this video all the way through. I really had a great time making this video. It took a lot of effort. Not all of the images are mine. I asked permission for a few people, and I just took a little bit of things that I found on the internet, but anything source, barb was mine, but I didn't, oh, and a little bit of assassin, but not the trailer video. But I didn't have time to do every single character. As you can see, I'm living in a tent. deployed, and that just wasn't an option, guys. So thank you so much for watching this video all the way to the end. If you made it all the way to the end, please put hashtag POD. Peace the fuck out.